Hello children, good morning. Welcome for today's biology class. So today we are going to continue the chapter, Why Do We Fall Ill? So today we are going to cover the means of spread of infectious diseases. How the infectious diseases being spread from the diseased person to healthy person. Okay children, so first let us see the means. So first one you see here, through air. So mainly airborne diseases, they spread by means of air. So different type of methods are there, the spread of diseases. It can be through air, water, food, vectors, physical contact, sexual contact, etc. So airborne diseases, common cold, so here you can add COVID also, tuberculosis and also pneumonia, etc. coming under this category. So from diseased person to healthy person through droplets. Okay, through cough and through air, no, it is being spread from one person to another person. So that's why while sneezing and all, no, you have to close your mouth with the help of kerchief like that. Otherwise, wearing mask, you see here. So by means of wearing mask, we can prevent COVID also. One more preventive method. So like that, common cold and tuberculosis, pneumonia are coming, spread by means of air contact. Next one, through water, cholera, amoebic dysentery and all by means of water. So if the water is not safe to drink, it is no unclean, then it will carry all the disease causing organisms. So that's why you have to take safe drinking water. You know children, normally during rainy season the water gets infected, so that's why we have to boil the water, we have to use filters. So always we have to prefer clean drinking water. So here, air droplets by means of air, how is it being spread from one person to another? When a person cough, no, then small droplets, it will evaporate and it will go to far away place, because the droplets, when it is small, it can be carried by air currents. For some, it can be floating in air also for some more time. If the larger droplets are there, they will settle down in few seconds. So that's why more dangerous is small particles. It is being carried for longer distance, also it will remain also for longer time. So common cold, cough, and apart from that COVID also, by wearing mask and while sneezing or coughing, you have to be closing your mouth, then automatically being away from the person by segregating, by social, maintaining social distance. Maintaining social distance, we can control this type of diseases, we can prevent the disease also. So next one, through vectors. So vectors, no, they are some, they may be some insects or some organisms. It is being spread from the diseased person to healthy person. It is very common example, you know, that malaria. So the female anopheles mosquito, mainly, no, it will female anopheles mosquito, because female anopheles mosquito only, it depend upon blood as its food. But the male anopheles mosquito, they take the plant sap. So that's when female anopheles mosquito, once it bite the infected person and later it is biting the healthy person, automatically it carried from the diseased person to healthy, the same way the dengue fever and the yellow fever and all being spread. Then flies, okay, flies, you know, always they sit in dirty places. After sitting there once upon, if they come and sit upon your food, then automatically you can get the infection of, no, typhoid and tuberculosis, microorganisms, no, and even diarrhea, even food poisoning can occur, dysentery. Okay, so that's why always, no, we have to close your food. You should not leave your food open, then it will be exposed to house flies. Normally you can see more house flies during rainy season. So that's why you should be protect yourself from mosquitoes and flies. You know, for mosquitoes we can use mosquito repellents or nets, mosquito creams are there, by different ways we can protect. For flies also you have to close your food, then automatically if you keep your surroundings clean and also, and there won't be stagnant water nearby your home, automatically you can prevent the diseases spread by means of vectors. Next is through sexual contact. It is syphilis, AIDS and all being spread. So AIDS, apart from that, it is spread through blood transfusion and from mother to her child also during pregnancy. Okay. Next one, organ specific and tissue specific manifestations. Some diseases, normally the disease causing microbes, when they enter in the body, they will go to different organs and tissues. They focus upon a particular tissue or particular organ and they affect. For example, you see here in the case of tuberculosis or maybe any microorganism infecting lungs, no, they enter through nose and they likely to go to lungs, you know, common cold also, pneumonia, tuberculosis, and even COVID virus also. So they do like that, they attack, then automatically the malfunctioning of the particular organ will occur. It can result in death of the person also according to the severity of the attack. And next one, the microbes, no, they enter inside the mouth. Normally what do? They go to the gut, that is digestive system. So and they affect, for example, typhoid. And they can go to liver also, jaundice, you know, jaundice and typhoid and all. Typhoid is a foodborne disease, and this jaundice, it can be waterborne disease also. Okay, so it affects the liver and gut and you will suffer from the problem. So next, organ specific and tissue specific manifestation. Let us take the example of AIDS virus. So AIDS virus you can get by sexual contact or by blood transfusion also, and from mother to fetus by using contaminated needles one can get. So what does it do? It affects and damages the immune system. So during this time your immunity will become weakened. When the immunity is weakened, you will be getting all the type of infections. Acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. Your immunity will become deficient. So that's why you call that as AIDS. It is caused by HIV, human immunodeficiency virus. Next, Japanese encephalitis. It is a brain fever. So it enters the body through mosquito bite and once again it infects the brain. Like that, each and every microorganism, they affect a particular organ. They are focusing upon a particular organ and they will damage the particular organ according to the toxin produced by the organism. If the toxin, no, it is more toxic, it may damage the organ. If it is less toxic, it may be acute disease. It can be acute disease also, chronic disease also. So according to the means severity of the attack, how the organism attacks, how does it damages the particular organ, accordingly you will suffer from the problem. Okay children, so today we have covered organ specific and manifestations. It can be asked in 2 mark questions or even 3 marks also. By taking examples you prove different organ specific and tissue specific manifestations. Okay, and the means of spread of infectious diseases. So here we studied, no, 4 means of spread, that is through air, through water, and by means of vectors, and by sexual contact. Okay children, so it can be asked in 2 marks and sometimes it can be asked in 3 marks also by asking examples. Okay, so you have to prepare in all the way. So here also you are getting different terms and different diseases name. Okay, and you study thoroughly, and we will meet in next class. Whatever assignments given, no children, that also you complete it. Thank you children.